And then we'll have Solido, yep, come up here. You get your BCT loadout. Okay, and then let's see. I'm gonna get some night vision goggles real quick. Someone take mine. One other person take the other one.
He's good to go.
Okay, so. Alright, follow me. We're going to the map. We're going to use the map, and then we are going to the training field. And especially heavy, I want you to always be the last one to make sure all they are actually went to the next place, okay?
Roger, Simon.
To go to training.
Okay.
Line up. Cadre right behind me.
Sergeant B, I think looking back, say, okay.
Okay. So today we're going to go over, but during 3Ds, could one of you guys tell me, give me one of the 3Ds? Let's see, Private Dolan.
Direction.
Okay, Private. Salu?
Hey, what, sorry?
Give me one of the 3Ds.
Oh, man. I don't remember.
You don't know? Okay. So, Dolan said that, you know, direction. So, we have distance and subscription. Pretty much with direction you want to call out, like northeast, and then followed by, you know, what bearing.
Oh, yeah. Yes, I'm not used to hearing it in English. Sorry.
Yeah. And then distance is going to give you, like, roughly, like, in how far they are and stuff like that, like 400 meters, stuff like that. So Christian is like calling out, you know, if there's civilians unarmed, or if you see like a squad side element or a recon group of two guys with weapons, that's, you know, could be possibly a danger or danger close. So pretty much I'm going to place, let's see. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, you boys can go ahead and come to the training field. Okay. Let me find him. Okay, so you can go and look around. So
hello.
For me looking around, I saw we have a civilian. Actually, so I'll say contact, north bearing 10, approximately 20-25 meters, unarmed civilian. So that way, you see it, Nolan?
Yeah, I was all looking at it.
Oh, okay. You should move your head around. So that's what you have to do. Do you guys have compass, right? Everything?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay, sweet. All right, so I'm going to have Mr. Wretch move that ceiling somewhere. I cannot hear him. Okay. Okay, so one of you guys, who want to go first?
I'll go first.
Okay, go ahead.
Bearing 260, one contact, about 40 meters, unarmed civilian.
Good job, good job. Mr. Rich, gonna move him again, please. Oh, he's there. I think he's still got stolen. Yeah, I'll move him then. Okay. So, Private, go ahead.
Contact northwest, bearing approximately 320, about 10 meters. Civilian unarmed.
Good job. So you guys got the gif of what we have to do with that. Okay, so that is calling at contacts. Remember, your 3Ds. Let's see. Solito, go ahead. Tell me, give your 3Ds quickly.
Distance, direction, and description.
Okay. So let's go over here. And these are the vehicles that you guys will see on a battlefield. So I'm not going to give you too much details. So we will see pretty much the Euro a lot. And then you have two different kind of vehicles. We don't see a lot of tanks. So we see a lot of BTR.
Is this a guess?
Pardon?
Is this a guess?
Yeah.
I have the confusion between this and the other few.
So, voters on the nameplate, it's correct. And because you'll see the BTR and the BMP a lot. So these are the main ones, and plus a Euro, because they'll transport your, what you call it, the enemy. So, yeah. So let's go over here. And there's multiple types of Humvees. There's one is going to be the M2 and the Mark 19. So this is what you're probably be using a lot. Depends on the situation on the battlefield, okay? So for me, I'm the platoon doc. So this is what I usually drive. I drive that Humvee, and it's my favorite Humvee out of the whole thing. So I don't have any, shoot, bang, bang. I can focus on hitting people and drive. Okay, so this is BMT, MRAP. So it has the same thing as the, there's two variants of weapon system on it, BM2 and the Mark 19. And there is a smaller version of the MRAPs too that we use, especially in the first platoon. But I'm not familiar with second platoon. So we do have the Bradley in game, but we don't use that for transport of anything at the moment. We don't use it. We're not mechanized yet. There we go. So, yeah. Any question?
Nope.
Nothing really.
All right. I'm not sure what brawlers will be flying. Okay, so we had different version of Little Birds too. So that's one Little Bird that have a different kind of weapon system as well. Yep. That's what you're going to usually see. And this is awesome. I love, our pilots and stuff like that, because they do come in with Apache and give us awesome support in the air. So, yep. That's an awesome thing. Now, this is going to be something that you want to, is common to see the Blackhawk, because the Blackhawk, they use it for transport from a soldier from the base to come to us on the field if they actually died and got respawned. So that's something they go on, so it'll be easy and, hard to hit, because it's kind of like the medium size. Now, with this big boy, we got the Chinook, that big old mama. Okay, with the big old, you know, with the Chinook and stuff like that, of course it'll transport like huge amount of soldiers. So it's kind of fun to go in there, but always remind, be quiet if you're going, you know, in their helicopters or their planes. Okay. Any questions so far? So I'll give you to Hibby. Hibby will go over by the radio.
Right, open up your radio control P. Start from top to bottom. Top one is your decrease and increase volume. So you left click, it'll decrease, and you have your information box in the bottom right hand corner. Both seen?
Can you remember real quick?
So just click that up to the 100% and it tells you your radio type.
Control P.
Sorry?
Say again, control P, right?
Control P to open up your radio interface, yeah. And you should see a lovely little radio. Do you have a shortwave radio?
Yes.
Excellent. Do you see the interface in front of you?
Yes, yes. I see.
Right, so black central dial at the top that has the numbers on it, that is your volume control. So as I said before, if you click left click on your mouse, it will decrease the volume. Right click, it will increase the volume. And it tells you in the bottom right hand corner on your radio information box what type of radio you have, what volume setting it's at, and which stereo settings it's at. If you see that, say aye.
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 Happy days. Right, let's work our way down. Right, so you'll see your LED display. That tells you your channel and your frequency. Right, so I want you to be on channel 1, which is what your should standard be, and I want you to go on frequency 111. So to do that, hit CLR, which is clear frequency. Enter 111 and ENT, which is set frequency. Once you've done that, take an E.
It just put again the random generated frequency, not 111.
Right, so go to channel 1, hit CLR. Right. Type in 111 on your keyboard. Hit ENT to enter and set frequency. You good?
It still says 205.7.
Have you hit clear, CLR?
Yes, there's right, four and seats, and I type 111.
Right, so you now have 111 as your frequency, yes? Take a knee, please. If you've got 111, take a knee. Cavillo, you okay? Right, so now, hopefully we're all on the same radio frequency. I will do a radio check. I will call your name out on the radio. And I just want you to say Lima Charlie or loud and clear back so I know that you can hear me. Okay?
Alright.
You press the caps lock key and to be able to talk on the radio.
I didn't hear anything.
Right, 2 seconds.
Golden radio check, you can see 111. Over.
Lima Charlie.
Lima Charlie.
Right, so you can both hear me, happy days. Right, so that's your standard one radio channel, right? So open up your radio, control P. So you know how to clear a frequency, you know how to set a frequency. Next, so if you go down to the bottom row, you'll see a thing which is on the zero key, it says stereo settings. Click that, and you'll notice in the right-hand corner, it on your radio information display, it'll tell you that it's left only, right only, or left and right.
Right, your team channel always comes through your right ear. Right, so change that until it goes right only. Once you've done that, stand up.
What? Say again.
Right, I want you to press the zero key until your stereo settings, which is in the bottom right-hand corner, says right only.
Sorry, I can't understand you very well. What key?
Zero key on your radio display. It says stereo settings. Click that, and in the bottom right-hand corner, it will change it to right only. Once you've got right only, stand up. Half a days. Right, so now I'm going to talk to you on the radio, and it should only come through your right ear. If it does, shout aye.
Stereo settings check, frequency 111.
Aye.
Aye.
Happy days. Right, so now we are going to set up a second, an additional channel. And the reason we've set the one channel on our right ear, and we're going to set the second channel on our left ear, is because then when you hear the communication coming through, you know which channel is speaking to you. Seems sensible?
Yep.
Right, okay. Now, we are going to go press number 2 on your keyboard pad. That will take you to channel 2, okay? I want you to clear that and set that to 222. Then hit enter. Right, once you've done that, take a knee. Colin, are you on it?
Yeah. I think I got it.
Right, so now we've got two channels, but we can't communicate on both of them at the same time because they're set up as two different channels. But we do have a way of doing that. So now, open up your radios again. Be on channel 2222. Right, so you will see the left arrow on the bottom row, which just says set additional channel. Click that until it says A2222. Shout aye when you've done it.
Mine says A1.
Right, because you're in the wrong channel. You should be on channel 2, frequency 222.
How'd you hit the channel 2? You said hit 2.
Press 2 on your number pad, on your keyboard.
Yeah, that doesn't work for me.
I think
what, right? You can use the PRE, you'll see channel up, channel down.
Oh, all right.
So, get that sorted, get yourself to channel 2, frequency 222. And then set your additional channel so it says A2222. Once you've done that, shout aye.
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 Good days. Right, so now, this second channel is going to be through both ears, so I want you to change your stereo settings, which is a zero on your interface, to be left only. So you'll see your interface will now say radio type, volume, right only, additional, left only. Once you've seen that, stand up and shout aye.
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 Right, so Dolan, just want you to check your press channel 1, press to go back to channel. I just want to make sure that's on the correct one before we go to the next part.
Alright.
So you're on C1111, correct?
Yep.
Happy days. Right, so we now can communicate and listen on two separate channels. So we have an additional channel, which is T for Tango. To chalk on, so I'm going to do a radio check on that. So press T to talk on your additional channel.
I didn't hear anything when you said, if you right. Said something.
Right, so open up your radio. Right, Control P.
Yep.
Go to channel 1, what does it say?
111.
Right, it says C1111.
Yeah, C1111.
Right, go to channel 2, what does it say?
A2222.
Right, so your radio is set up correctly, happy days. So we'll try that again.
Radio check, additional channel 222, over.
Name of channel.
So Dillo, you hearing that?
Lima Charlie.
Upstairs. Right, so channels are now set up, coming through separate ears. Right, so now how do you talk in the radio? The way I always remember it is, hey you, this is me. Right, so for me, if I was talking to my squad leader, I would do something along the lines of this.
One, this is Ghost 1-2. Radio check, over.
So I'm saying one, because he's one. He's Ghost 1, and my is 1-2. Right, so basically, I'm speaking to my fire team leader there, and then basically he would report back with along the lines of send it, etc., etc. Yeah, so it's always, hey you, this is me, and then wait for the reply, because they, obviously, if you're speaking to somebody above you, they may have five people speaking at the same time, and you don't know that because you're not listening to all their nets, but always wait for your reply. If you don't get a reply back within a minute or two, send it again, or if it is high priority, i.e. you're getting attacked, etc., you can basically just go in and say, break, this is a high priority message for Ghost 1, this is Ghost 1-2, and then you'll know you've got important information to give them. Everybody happy with that?
Yep.
Right, so Dolan, you are Big Dog 5, and Cedillo, you are Big Cat 5. Okay? Oh, I am Big Elephant 1. Send me a radio report.
Big Elephant 1, this is Big Dog 5, over.
Big Dog 5, send it.
Your hair's looking very nice today.
Right, on you go, Sid.
Sorry, I didn't hear my call sign.
You are Big Cat 5.
Sorry. Say again, please, more slow.
Big Cat 5.
Okay. And what was your call sign? Sorry.
I'm Elephant 1.
Elephant 1?
Elephant 1, yes.
Hey, Elephant 1. Here's Big Cat 5. Over.
Big Cat 5, send it.
Nice hat you got there.
Are you finished?
We are.
Cool. So we'll do map reading, and after that we'll do the formation. So, Private Cedillo and Private Dolan. Do you guys know how to use the map, read the map?
Yes.
You do know? Okay. Private Cedillo, you do know that?
Kind of.
Okay. Good. So I'll just re-explain it real quick, right? So if you guys open up your map, right, and scroll all the way out, we are at the blue marker training field, right? If you zoom in on our position, you should see that I marked something down there, right? Do you have visual on that?
Yep.
Okay, yep. Good. So, the way we read the map, right, is, let's say we are currently in this is our current position, right, sorry, with the green circle right now, right? And what we do is we read the horizontal values, and then we read the vertical values, right? So if you see, we have the 100 by 100 grid here. This is our 100 by 100 grid. And at the top and at the bottom of the map screen, you have values, right? Do you guys have a visual on that?
Yes.
Right. Private Cedillo, what's the value there?
037023.
All right, okay. You already did both, right? So 037 is our horizontal value. Our vertical value is 023, right? So, easy. If you zoom a little bit out, about a kilometer to the south, I have two markers with a green flag, right? So, Private Cedillo, if you can give me a grid reference on the number one marker.
033035.
Okay. And Private Dolan, if you give me one on the number two marker.
Do you want keypad two, or...?
Without keypad for now.
Alright, 035, 039.
Okay, good. So, back to the training field. At Private Dolan just talked about, we have a keypad. Private Cedillo, you know what a keypad is?
I kind of know it from squad, but just a little bit.
Okay, so just imagine we have a 100 by 100 grid square, right? And now, for example, for CAS and LZ or Mortar Strike, we want a more accurate position, right? So what we do is we tell the person our grid, followed by keypad, and then a certain number. And it's super simple. Just look at your numpad, right, on your keyboard, and imagine to you'd copy that and put it onto the 100 by 100 grid, just as I did, right, south of us. And depending now where within that 100 by 100 grid you are, you do say the correct number. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Okay, good. So, Private Dolan, if you can give me the keypad for the flag with the number 1. So, grid reference plus keypad.
Grid 033035, keypad 4. Or 5.
5, right. Okay, good. And Private Cedillo, if you do it for number 2.
Grid 035039, keypad 8.
Perfect. Alright, that's it. Do you have any questions?
Okay.
Then we're good to go for formation. Sergeant B.
Mr. Wretch?
Yes, please.
Blue here. What channel setting do they have on the map?
I made it on global.
Thank you.
So, Sergeant B, do you want to take him over?
So, could one of you guys give me one example for like what the advantage of it for line formation?
It provides more fire concentration to the front. It's primarily used in like base of fire support.
Yeah, you're good. It's a like strong firepower to the front, and then. And then it's easy to maintain and stay stationary. So, yeah, fun. Can someone give me... Dolan, can you give me disadvantage with the line formation?
There's not a lot of firepower towards the like flanks.
Yeah, so there is no flank at all. There's no security for the rear security because they're all pointing to the front. So they're difficult to maintain on the move. And possible use is maybe like crossing the hill or moving through a wooden terrain. Okay, let's come over here. So, can someone tell me what this is? Let's see.
Dolan. Column.
Okay. So, give me the advantage of that, Dolan.
It's easier to maneuver, so if you're going through like tight pathways or anything like that.
Yep. It's a maximum front part directed to towards the front, and then easy to maintain when stationary, and yeah. So again, there is no security in the back, no rear security, and if it's one shot from a 50 cal, right? They will die. Like, all of them die. Like, and then, let's see. Possible use is going to be situation like which required rapid movements, urban environments, and. I can't say it today. Never mind. Like, kind of like Denise or whatever terrain.
Sense.
Yep. So, you guys got my gif. Let's go to the next one. So, Dylan, what is this?
It's a wedge.
And what kind of wedge?
Heavy, right?
Good job. Okay. So, Solito, give me one advantage on this one.
DDCC to maneuver?
Kind of. It's
not easy. As easy as a column, but it's relatively easy because you have a point man leading the march.
Like, yeah. And then, it has good security, provides minimally and balance of any fire direction, and allows for good spacing. Okay. So, don't only give me one disadvantage. Why? For the wedge. If you don't know it, just you can always tell me. Don't worry, you're still alive. Okay. Do you know
what? Hold on. Sorry, I had a telephone call real quick.
Not a problem. Give me disadvantage, please.
Oh, it's there's no rear protection.
Well, there is still kind of, well, yeah, of course, because they're looking in front, but they can easily turn around as well. So it's not too bad. The disadvantage, it's wide and takes up a lot of space and difficult to maneuver it. So, it'd be kind of a little challenging with that. Possible use assaulting a location, a move to the enemy location is unknown. So, if the location is unknown, then this is a good way to actually be in. Okay, so let's go over this one. Okay, so Dolan, tell me what this one is.
It's a echelon.
Okay, so there's different variant on this. It'd be left and right. So this is actually a left echelon. So, Celio, can you tell me this one? The advantage for it, like one advantage.
It is easy for the fire team leader to control the formation because he can see every member in the fire team.
Well, the thing is that being, you know, running with your fire team anyways, the fire team leader don't have to worry about, you know, anybody because you need to call that, it's called trust, so, pretty much the advantage on this one is going to be towards, it's actually excellent security towards the front and as a single flank, good frontal security. This advantage would be poor security on the opposite flank, possible use situation within where the enemy is concentrated into one flank. Passing through town, passing a confirmed hostile. Okay. So this one's going to be called Stagger Column. Pretty much the advantage on this one is excellent on flank security and easy to maintain effective security. And everybody knows their angles. And it's good spacing. Disadvantage can be poor frontal security. Difficult to form and maintain. And it breaks down when traveling through obstacles. So, possible use would be like good for urban like streets and stuff like that. Or roads. Like if we're going like, on a hike, whatever. It's going to have a staggering column so no one doesn't get wiped. And over here, we have 360 security. So, give me, let's see. Hibby, give me an example why we do 360 security.
360 security, so we have eyes and guns pointing out around the entire section or platoon, or in this case, a fire team. So, we've got eyes in every direction. So, if the enemy approach, we are going to see them, and there's going to be a gun pointing in that direction, and it'll tell us where they're coming from. We use this for things like you can move it a VIP, protect VIP in the middle, or if you are in known enemy territory, very slow to move, but you have people. Oh, people going with eyes in all directions. So if you know there's hostiles all around you, at least in this one, you have somebody facing in the correct direction.
You'll put your night vision goggles on. They need to fix night vision goggles on here. It's so disgusting.
So okay. Great for perimeter security, having every time you stop, get your fire team or your etc. Everybody goes on 360. Everybody's watching outward from the middle. And if you see anybody approaching, call it in to your fire team leader.
Any questions?
No.
All right, follow me.
It's probably going to keep happening due to the fact that they're doing EIB.
Alright, you want to scroll down, go all the way down to rifle qual?
Should be M16A2.
Yep, M16A2 rifle. So, do you guys need to, do you guys need to take a break and take a piss, get some water? You guys need to do that?
No, I'm good.
Wait a sec.
Okay, you got 5 minutes then. Go on a crouch if you're leaving. Mr. Rich, can you put some lights on two lanes over here?
No.
I can do that.
Yeah, just in case they turn off the lights again.
Alright, so if the lights go out while we're shooting, and that screws them up, we'll just discard the count and make them redo it.
Okay, so the lights off, they still got 4 attempts then?
Yeah.
Okay.
Depending on what attempt they're on, if that makes sense.
Yep. And they reset that what attempt they're on, they start again. Gotcha. I plan to be the medical standby, but yeah, this is more important.
Okay, I'm back.
Okay. So, this is going to be your rifle call. You pass your line, my friend. Okay, so this would be rifle qual. Technically, a total of 4 attempts, including your practice round. So there is total your scorebook kind of up to 40. So it'd be 40 targets. I believe there's gonna be prone, crouch, and standing. Those are the three things you go through. Don't worry, we got some lights for you guys. So the target pops up for at least, 5 seconds and it goes down. Of course, you'll see, there's scoreboards and stuff. Oh, what crap. Scoreboards and stuff that we'll see and watch for. So to qualify on this one, you must... for just marksmen to qualify is going to be between 23 to 29 and be of course out of 40, and then sharpshooter is going to be 30 out of 35 for sharpshooter, and 36 or above it's going to be expert. So for example, your first try that you got, if you got 35 and then it's like, oh, I want to try for expert, you can. But if your second attempt goes down to 29 to a marksman, we cannot go back to your first score. Just always remember that, okay? So if your first attempt that you got on expert, then I recommend you not retry that score. If you got 36 minimum for expert, keep it. If it's higher than that, awesome. Okay, any questions so far?
Nope.
Nope.
Okay, follow me real quick. Can you guys see all the way down to the other barracks, the H barriers? Can you see the final target?
Yeah, I can see them.
Yeah, I can just see.
Okay. So, you look at this computer when you don't mess with it right now. But with the computer, you can actually scroll, prepare qualifications, and it'll give you the the gun stuff like that. And make sure it's on single mode. You don't want it on auto or burst, because you're gonna lose all your ammo so quickly. So if you shot a target, you shot a target and it missed, don't shoot again until the target pops down and pop a new target. And then it will automatic reload for you, I believe. And yeah, it's pretty that simple. And then you just follow whatever the computer tells you to. So I'm gonna have let's see, Hibby, pick one.
Dolan, because he's easy on them to say.
And then let's see, Mr. Rich.
Private Cedillo, yeah. Yeah, come with me, Private Cedillo.
So I was away there, Sergeant B. Have you shown them the mechanics how to start it and stuff?
Yeah, I told them.
I know how to do it.
So there's basically no distance markers here, so we just have to guesstimate the distance to the far for this target.
Blair, follow me.
Have you had a practice run of this before, Dolan?
Oh, yeah.
How did you go on?
I think it
was... Dang it, I don't have my gun to shoot the ghost.
Where?
So I just prepared qualifications? The ones closer to me, left and right and center, and far back, I see three, no, two, they're in the shadows, and in front of them, there are another two.
You got any questions so far? Did you buck?
No, I haven't had anything.
I think it's kind of worse, but I don't really know, because the...
I'm just waiting for scores to come in now so I can put them in the book.
It's kind of going to block the thing, so it's going to be hard anyway.
Should we be on Whisper? To Lugenbach, the score, so he can put down the paperwork. Pardon?
Should we be on Whisper?
You know what? I'm going to use the normal.
Pretty straightforward. I like this.
Different feel at nighttime.
Yeah.
Actually, you have more contrast on the targets, so that makes it easier.
Yeah, I really feel like it does.
I like it because
so
it's all straightforward. Like, that's one thing I love about this kind of stuff.
I mean, you either pass or you fail. There's no second guessing it.
Yep. No bullshitting. God, I want to unfuck my prison. I've been playing Prison Architect.
Oh, yeah? How fucked is it?
Completely fucked.
You like building games?
I play more like MMOs, and then so
I get so here.
I'm going Whisper. Like yesterday, I got so pissed off during someone orientation, because he made me repeat myself like 5 times. I was getting so pissed off and heated.
leader has patience.
Oh, I was patient, but I was like...
patient, but pissed off.
Yeah, I was pissed off. And, like, and it fucked up. Okay, but the thing is, let's, like, first thing I woke up, do this guy rotation, made me do this and do that, repeat myself. Like, when I woke up, like, I don't want to repeat myself. Like, I'm speaking...
Oh, and then TeamSpeak was fucked up, too.
Yeah, TeamSpeak got screwed yesterday.
They just pop up immediately?
Somebody needs to have a talk with Sabios, Leo, whatever it is. He doesn't have to always talk over the radio.
Oh, good. That's a good point.
The private?
Yeah. Yeah. Ever since he started talking on the radio earlier during the training for the radio, he has not stopped talking on the radio. He doesn't talk like we are right now. He only talks on the radio right now.
Yeah, I tend to do that too much, too.
Change stuff real quick. It's his settings that he has. I think he has push talk for in TeamSpeak as well.
Probably. I'm just saying that he needs to change it. So
he probably has a mouse push to talk for his radio.
Maybe. I don't know.
Not mouse. It'd be like.
Yeah, I think they.
His radio is only used the cap lock. That's the only thing is default automatic.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
See, this is easy training for you. Just gotta even refresh because you went through this before.
Yeah, it wasn't that long ago that I went through it.
I like the changes in the map. It runs a lot smoother.
Yeah, I like the setup of where the vehicles are and everything, how they're all labeled up and have signs and everything with them.
Yeah, I noticed that you have to get within 2 meters for the sign to be readable. The sign's black until you get close enough.
Yeah. Because frame would drop if it's already there and people can see it.
One of the signs was knocked over.
You can take him to the pistol range.
This is one having 2 computers and 3 monitors sitting here is really helpful.
Cool. I've just got 2 monitors up, but it is handy.
I have 2 monitors and my laptop, so I have...
Oh, you got... I don't have a laptop. Yeah.
Yeah, I have my laptop set up, and I'm running the spreadsheet or the
right
journal for all scores on it.
Sharpshooter?
Stand by, I'm working on that.
Yeah, I think I can do more, but I'm kind of scared of not doing the same score again. Like, committing the same error of not seeing pretty much all the targets that popped up at the beginning of the test. I think I'm gonna stay with Sharpshooter. Yeah, it's kind of a good score, I think.
Copy,
yeah, I have a question. What is this qualifications thing? Marksman, sharpshooter? So...
Is he going to be going again, or is he good with that one?
Yeah, it doesn't really matter.
All right.
No, I'm kind of nervous. I want to have a higher score than my partner, Dylan.
Okay. Okay, just move to pistol range. That's where we're all moving to. Follow me, boys.
Let's go to the pistol range.
People.
Yeah, scroll down menu is hard to read in night vision.
Right, first round, second round coming up, reload. Quick, they're up. Right, and interact with the.
Where's your
thing
guy?
Sit.
Mr.
Rex. 15 out of 15, first round.
Yeah, sorry.
Hey, Top, I think we should have this slice around the location as well, just in case this happens.
Yeah, I'm gonna talk to Anderson when I'm done talking to him about the other things.
Okay.
Alright, qualification over. Side arm away and take a step back from the range. Can you?
I don't know if the new ops of course
Sergeant
works.
B, this is heavy Dolan 30 out of 30.
I think they put the old one in.
Oh, they're behind us.
Copy 30-30.
Visually, just one.
Let's rock and roll, mate. Well done.
What's that? Scoot the grenades.
Ops of course is that way.
In the dark, this should be fun.
You can run that way.
Right, you ready? Ready? Let's rock and roll. It's lighting up, we're good. Right, so two experts in a row. Have you had a practice at this?
I did the new one.
Oh, but are we doing the new one?
It's not done yet. Mo's still making it. But...
Sergeant B, are we just running the old one, yes? Cool. Right, so, let's go across here. We'll just do a walkthrough, okay?
Right.
Feet on the block. Right, so here, zigzag through basically. Front. Right, zigzag through. Right. Over.
Wait, I'm permanently working. How do I stop this? I'm permanently working.
Under, crawl. Remember, you can sprint whilst prone as well. That's it. Crouch under.
Yeah, my character is just permanently working. I can't, like, jump.
Yeah, you stick if you run.
Control B. Yeah.
Alright, and then over. And happy days to the end. Right? You know what we do each obstacle?
Yep.
Why does it happen?
Right, okay. So this is obviously a timed event. Give me 2 seconds till I get my clock up.
qualify in another instance, like to have a perfect score or something.
Alright, Dolan, tell me when you're ready.
Alright, I'm ready.
Yeah, but I mean, it's just for personal accomplishment.
1, 2, 3, go.
Okay. Just come up here.
Yeah, I'm kind of trying to see.
Come
so
on,
zigzag.
Get up and over there.
Six.
Double time, go, go, go.
Alright, 24 seconds.
Yeah,
24. Oh, 24. Good job.
No. Okay, control V for climbing.
Sergeant B.
I'll show you. Watch. Just watch me. Just go on the opposite side over there. On the side of the fence. Watch.
Right. So Dolan, all three exercises are with me today. Passed as expert.
Yeah.
Continue up the good work, and you'll hopefully do that next week as well.
Yeah, the standard B.
Grenade.
Yeah, frags.
Doing frags today.
Yeah, you do frags today. It's 2 or 3s.
Ah, frags today, right, okay. Right, okay then, so good luck with your next one. Can we be able to frags now?
Yeah, you can go for the frags.
Okay. So control V for that part, okay. You tell me one.
You'll see a little arsenal box beside us. Alright, go to that. You may need a backpack.
Well, just let me remember the steps. So, control V on that part. Oh, I don't have to run there. Double time there.
So
okay,
there
got
is. See the targets in front of us?
Yep.
Alright, so there's 5 sets of targets. Eyeball them all?
Yeah, I can see them.
Alright, okay, so each one we are going to go along and I'm going to identify the target to you. You're going to acquire the target. I'm going to give you permission to throw. You're going to throw, and after you've thrown it to you, so hit the deck. Once the grenade goes boom, we stand up and see how you have hit the target. All the 3 men have to go down for each target for it to be classified as a hit.
So I'm good.
Any questions?
Nope. It's
right,
it's control G, right?
For the different types of throws, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Right, so are you happy to go for it?
Yeah, I'm good.
I think you... Is Top still here? Yes, Top. Is he still here?
Yeah, I'm here. What's up?
How many practice throws does he get?
You can give him like 2 or 3.
Okay.
So you can get 2 or 3 practice throws. I would recommend the rear ones because the front
ones
are easy.
Yeah, probably here is when I'm going to fail.
I reckon the one behind the little flan tower.
Probably here is when I'm going to fail. Thrown a grenade.
I've practice throw each one of the rear ones. And obviously... We'll go for it, so we'll
in armor, yes, but not
right.
With RHS or ace. I know that ace has the ability to throw grenades in different ways, like over shoulder, long, just
right,
drop it.
I think that one's short.
Okay.
Okay.
Right, target's down, good hit. Right, might as well go back left then, because that's the other tricky one. Back left, okay. Target acquired.
Target down.
Free to fire.
Throw out.
Yeah.
Good hit. Right, you happy?
Yeah, yeah.
Make sure you have 5 frags then.
Yeah, I have like 12. I hit it twice, so...
Ah, right, so you went mad for it. Right, okay, so I'm going to call you out the target. You're going to throw the grenade at it.
So, from left to right,
practice we've done there before. So, we'll start with easy ones. We'll go for front right.
Target acquired. Am I good to throw?
Beat your fire.
Fire out.
Okay.
Good hit.
So it's going to be like target acquired, frag out,
target acquired.
Immediately go prone.
Which one did you say?
Center.
Oh, okay.
Near.
Yeah, target acquired.
Fire.
Frag out.
Good hit. Front left. Target acquired.
Target acquired.
Beat your fire.
Frag out.
Frag out. Yeah, not in that precise order. But...
Good hit. Back right.
Target acquired.
Target acquired.
Yeah, target acquired.
Beat your fire.
Frag out.
Frag out.
Nope, miss. Short. Back left.
Target.
Target. Beat your fire.
Target. Where? Frag out.
Good hit. 4 out of 5. This is heavy Dolan, 4 out of 5.
I wanted to bounce off the
right,
there.
45 still expert, mate, so you're still on course.
The sandbags, but
okay.
It kind of messed up the shot and blew up the
right, so let's find out where we need to go next. I think we're done, apart from the... what's your cover?
Alright.
Right. Hibby, do you want us to go back to base, or do you just want us to wait here?
I really prefer the ace way. Yeah, target acquired.
Maybe, can you see, hear Sadio on your left ear?
I can hear him, yes.
Yeah, I can hear him.
What's the problem?
His noise just seems like he's going through his...
No, his caps up key is definitely his...
He's talking on radio all the time. Just whoever's with him, tell him to do it direct.
Yeah, that's right.
Say again, Dolan.
Yeah, that happened to me like when I was doing this before with Mo. That was happening to me. So,
what was it, Dolan?
Space.
Right. So, we're having a problem. Right. So, we're going back to base, and then we'll just do a quick rundown. The material that you've learned today, just to make sure it's all in the brain, while we're waiting on you go to finish. Happy?
Try it.
Let's rock and roll.
Okay, this is gonna hurt. Target where?
Hey, Dolan, here, mate. Right, quick rundown of everything you've learned today. 3Ds, name them.
Distance, direction, description.
It is. Your radio, you were okay with that. What's the radio interface? How'd you get it up?
What was it?
How do you get your radio interface up?
Oh, Control-P.
Up it is. Right, okay. Vehicles, what is our standard vehicle that we use 99% of the time?
the transport truck or the Humvees.
So that's lit. And what is the main troop carrier for Brawlers?
For who?
Brawlers. Aeroplane people. People in the air. Shiny bums.
Oh, the Blackhawk.
Blackhawk, right. So that's what I'll come up with. We, as platoon, we go out in the big tunic thing. Because that can take near enough the whole platoon out. Yeah, so we good with that. The formations. If you were about to crest the hill and assault the position, what formation would you be in?
Line.
Up a days. If you are going through urban terrain and you're splitting your forces, how would you? Which formation would you use for that?
Splitting your forces.
Splitting your forces.
So staggered column.
Staggered column. Happy days, and that's that done. Tap me on the shoulder.
Base.
Rich, do you need medical?
So if you look at me and go interact key, rather than self-interact, you'll see tap on shoulder.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Alright.
Mm-hmm. Happy days. Hib. Right, okay. Sergeant B, done with all.
Come on, take him. We're going to do formations, so let's go over here, follow me.
I thought you were, like, pointing at something behind me.
Rich, are you, NCIC or anything?
No. I'm EMC lead, so for all the maps.
Okay, so today we're going to go about the ceremony, because tomorrow is ceremony, so this is something that you want to, you know, learn. So, trainees, go here. Cadre, go into formation. Line up. I don't care which one you want to go into, but make sure you guys are all together. Top, would you like to be the captain for today?
Nope.
All right.
Real quick.
Did you already explain it?
Not yet. So, you guys come over here real quick. See, one thing, they have gap. They're not even lined up. They're not in the correct formation. Come on, you guys should know this. Cover up. Blue hair. There's still a gap. They're not even lined up. So make sure you guys line up to the person that who's on the that block. Which to the right, and you want to make sure you have total of six people online. So Hibby's lining up with blue hair. So go ahead and fill in that spot real quick. All right here. Oh wait, never mind. So make sure you go ahead and line up with the guy. So every formation, this is what we do for every ceremony. So you always want to remember to do that. And then I'll have Rich will go explain more about it, and then he can use the cadre first for, you know, showing you guys the correct way to do it. So go ahead, Rich, take over, Mr. Rich.
Okay. So I guess Sergeant B already told you a couple of the commands here we use. One of them, right, being the cover up, right? The soldiers are to cover up, fill in the gaps we have in the formation, make sure we all nice and aligned on the slab you're standing on right now, facing to the front. once you're in that position, right, try to minimize your movement. Like, don't move around. You can push people around, so just don't do that. Keep still, face to the front, and don't talk, right? So then, another order is post, right? So it will be a name, a rank name, and then post, right? So for example, First Sergeant Went, post. Right, so he takes a step back, and then comes up to the front. And then that was fast. Then you're gonna salute, right?
Am I not saluting now?
No, you're not.
No.
Right, then I'll respond to that. And once I stop the salute, he will drop his salute, right? And then I say, about face. He will turn around over his right shoulder, right? Facing the formation. Now say, First Sergeant Wend is an excellent NCOIC. I don't really know anything about Game Insurgency or what he does or whatever, so he won't get a medal for that. About face. That turns back, facing me. Salutes.
Why does it keep going down?
Because you're moving your mouse, I think. So, there we go, right? And then drops the salute again. Then fall in. So takes a step back, turns around, and moves the fastest way back to his position. Alright? Do you have any questions regarding this?
Nope.
Nope.
Alright. And Private Dolan and Private Cedillo, post.
Make sure you guys cover up to each other as well. You always want to. So if two guys come up together, make sure you know you're a little you guys good.
All right, about face. Right. Private Cedillo and Private Dolan today here did an excellent job participating in BCT. They did a good job on the rifle qual, the obstacle course, the grenade range, as well as during all our training lessons. They'll continue doing their OSIT, finishing it up with the AIT next week if possible, and become outstanding members of the unit. And the formation will call HUA!
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 HUA! There we go, alright, good. About face. Alright, fall in.
One tip, do not, because a lot of people will get, you know, angry if you run through the middle of the formation. You never want to do that, so try not to do that, okay?
So, like, going around the outside again?
Yeah, because because technically your platoon leader will be up here, and then, your platoon leader want you pass by so they can see you, be like, oh, yeah, whatever, like, without using
okay.
stuff, whatever.
So, we have to pass through the outsides of the formation then.
Yeah. Right. So, second platoon will be on that side, and this will always be on first platoon this side. So, majority of the guys here today is actually from first platoon, so that's where they choose on the side they want to be on.
Alright.
Any questions so far?
Nope.
Okay.
Nope.
So, I just want to say thank you, Kadri, for being here and helping out today. Appreciate you very much, and thank you, Top, for hanging out with us. It is such an honor to have, my boss here, hanging out. And then, you guys, thank you for showing up on time. Make sure all your mods are all correct at the beginning before you came on, and appreciate it very, very much. So, since you have
thank
any more
you.
Questions... I'm kind of like disappointed with Cedillo because you could have got expert on your M16 and got honors just for the BCT portion, but you didn't.
Yeah, I kind of messed up trying to use the night vision goggles. It just blurred all the image and I couldn't see many of the targets popping up.
Well, we had the lights too.
I'm not bragging, but I could have easily got the 36 points.
Yeah, I believe in you, but we have lights up ready to go for you guys too on the range.
And there's an opportunity to recall.
Yeah, but he cannot.
Yeah, I didn't choose to do that. I didn't want to mess up my score.
I wish I could Gibbs smack people around here.
So with top permission, do that permission leave?
Yeah, everyone's good to go.
Permission to leave?
Yep, just go ahead and leave, report out, and you guys good. You already got permission from top, so good job.
All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Have a good one, guys.
There you putting out.
Probably looking back reporting out.
I don't want to point out.
Buddy left your channel.
Where's this other corner?
Private city, you're falling out.
User left your channel.
All these dead bodies on my field. What the hell?
They're all